To work more efficiently in Maya, you should store your 3D scene and related asset files, such as textures and animation clips, by setting a project. A project is a collection of folders that Maya creates in order for you to centralize all your assets in one location, as opposed to leaving them scattered on your system. This is particularly useful when collaborating in a team, as you can easily share a project on multiple computers and maintain the path dependencies between scenes and their assets. In this movie, we'll set up and configure a new Maya project, as well as cover some workflow best practices. Open the project window from the file menu. Initially, Maya uses a default project located in your local user directory. Click the New button to create a new project and rename it to My New Project. You can set your project's location to a local folder or point to a shared network drive. Here, we'll leave it as is. Click Accept to create the project. The resulting project consists of a set of directories mirroring those listed in the project window. You'll also notice the new workspace.mel file. We'll come back to it in a bit. Now that you've set My New Project as the current project, Maya uses its folder structure to store its data formats. For example, if you open any dialog featuring a file browser, such as the Open Scene, Save Scene, Import, and Export All Windows, Maya automatically looks in the proper directory of My New Project for compatible asset files. The Current Project section lists the recently opened projects and their respective folder structure. This lets you quickly switch between locations instead of tediously navigating paths, especially if you're toggling between local and network projects. To set a different project from this list, click Set Project and then choose the desired folder. Note that you can also access Set Project from the File menu. Now let's go back to the project window to configure My New Project. As we've seen earlier, Maya creates a set of subdirectories within a project's root directory. To change them, click the corresponding folder icon and then pick a different directory. If you don't want Maya to associate a data type with its current directory, just leave its location blank. You can use Edit, Clear Settings to quickly wipe all locations clean, or use Reset Settings to revert the locations to their original directories. The Primary Project Location section contains high-level directories for the essential project data that you'll frequently access. The Secondary Project Location section lists subdirectories in the primary project locations, as well as other complementary data types. The Translator Data Location section refers to data exchange formats, such as DWG and FBX. Lastly, the Custom Data Location section lets you add custom file rules and locations based on your production pipeline. For example, you could create a new file rule to store data generated from a third-party plugin. Click Accept to apply all changes. Every time you make changes to your project folder, Maya updates the workspace.mel file, also known as the project definition file. This file is important as Maya cannot recognize a project without it. For example, if you set a project using an empty folder, Maya will ask you to either create a default workspace or pick a different folder. Note that creating a default workspace does not automatically generate the full set of directories that we've seen so far. To do so, you'll want to go back to the project window afterwards to configure your project to your liking. The project definition file contains MEL commands mapping each data type to their respective folder. If you update this file manually, you'll need to restart Maya to see these changes applied. Also note that Maya overwrites this file every time you update your project via the project window. Finally, let's cover general best practices regarding Maya projects. It's recommended that you set a project at the beginning of every new production. That way, if you need to archive your files or send them to someone else in your team, you'll reduce the chance of losing assets. On the other hand, if you've already started production and want to set it up as a project, you can simply create a new project in a separate folder and move your current production files into the resulting folder structure. If you rename your project's root folder, you need to reset it as the current project so Maya can maintain all its path dependencies. When you open a scene within a project, you also need to set the corresponding project as Maya does not do it automatically. If you're unsure of a project's data folder locations, consult its workspace.mel file. You can now try your hand at setting projects using any of the asset files available for download on the Maya Learning Channel.